In this tutorial, I will introduce a method of setting up simulation so it's possible to compare and analyze different proposals. Of course, you could look at just single results, but that is quite difficult to remember the difference between the different proposals. Therefore, there is a need of compare and analyze the different proposals and simulation. This gets possible when you have them listed up side by side. In this case, I have the context here and proposal 1 and proposal 2, and there could be more, of course. Of course, you could also set this up in some of the Adobe software like InDesign, Illustrator or Photoshop or even PowerPoint. But there is some advantages of doing inside the project. Then you have all your working documents inside the same file, so you don't have everything in single files all over. And especially when you work together with other people, then it's more efficient to have it placed in the same file, so everybody can have access to it. Because it's not possible to do this in Vasari, I need to do this in Revit, but all the simulation like the solar radiation and the wind simulation is done within Vasari. And in Vasari it's possible to do some of these simulation concerning the exterior spaces like wind simulation and solar radiation, but the problem is, as I mentioned, it's difficult to remember the difference, so there is a huge need of having these different proposals side by side, or even for your first traditional analysis of the site as an additional analysis within the tool. Of course, you can save these images to Vasari direct by going to output and say save to project, but one of the problems here, as I see it, that is it's difficult to control how much it takes of the project. You can of course choose different resolution or go to the Vasari icon and export as images, where you have better possibility of exporting images, but still I'm missing a little bit more freedom to edit and control these images. And if we look at the wind tunnel, then it's even more difficult to actually save images. It's actually not possible to do that. So for this I'm using the snipping tool, where I take a clip of the screen, as I will show you in another video. Back in Revit, just to explain a few steps I'm doing inside Revit to get these views. I'm working on sheets and put views on the sheets. The shadow range is a bunch of views with different time steps to create these shadows. We maybe can see over here in the browser. These are easy to create and have a real-time feedback when you change geometry. And this I'm showing in another video. The solar radiation, there's a overlay view of real Revit geometry, so to say, to get the sharp edges, as you maybe can see here. Then this is an image put on a drafting view like this, and I'm scaling this image in the same scale as the overlay drawing of the site. And the color legend is also a screen print from the simulation within Vasari that I import into a legend. The wind simulation, it is the same method. I have a drafting view with the different simulation images, so all images is put on drafting views. And a overlay model specific for the wind simulation, I like to highlight the site. And in here I can edit the image. I can use masking region to control how much of the image I want to see. So there's some workarounds to edit the size of the picture. And this one is a fillet region with some transparency to get this highlight effect. The legend is the same method as the solar radiation, and the full picture shown here. Of course, it takes a little bit of time to build this up and find out the right scale, but that process are you going through anyway if you're doing it PowerPoint, Adobe, whatever. And when you have done this, it's going much faster to set the next pages up. I think each of these takes around 15 minutes to set up when I have done it once. And first time it took around 4 hours to set it up in the right scale and so on. And in this way I can flip between the different proposals to read some of the results. And to summarize, this could have been amazing to have within Vasari, because it's related to this early stage of design that Vasari is built for. But here is some workarounds with doing it within Revit. In other videos I will show how to set up these views and other things in more detail. This was an introduction to how to visualize simulations.